the top off for any reason. That's a squeaker. If he'd have taken this off, there would have been a pipe down there. And that's down below. And some dirt could fall in here. When he put this back on, that dirt was down in there. And so when you turned it on, it come up and got plugged up. Plugged up this little tiny jet that's in here.
Yeah.
It don't take very much, just a little tiny hole. That's probably what happened. It worked for him because the dirt was down.
Oh.
When you turn it on, it had moved that dirt up. And when you turn it on, the dirt got up.
I see.
So that's why it worked for him, that's, and it didn't work.
Yeah, why?
It worked for him, but it didn't work for you. I stood there, I knew what everything was because I've had that happen so many times with myself.
Oh yeah?
Oh, I used to take off your sprinklers all over the park.
Oh.
Way back when.
Oh.
That's when the owner was the manager, the part owner. There was, I don't know, five or six people that owned all of this.
Yeah. Was it, let me see, was it, Ed?
No, Tilton Newell.
Oh, you know Ed?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
I used to, Ed used to have me do a lot of work.
Oh, I see.
I didn't work for the park. If there was something, like the bingo board wouldn't work. He'd say, hey Tom, we got bingo tonight, and we got some lights out, could you help me? I said, sure. So I go up and I fix the lights, then he'd pay me out of petty cash.
What?
Then he would pay me from petty cash. I wasn't on the payroll.
I see.
He would just pay me for the jobs he asked me to do.
And what the money, how much did you get?
Oh, 20, 30, 50.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
For?
It depends on how difficult the job was.
So how long would you take? How long?
Sometimes a half an hour, sometimes 3 or 4 days.
Oh, I see.
Get paid by the job, not by the hour.
Oh. And you just do it?
Yeah, it was extra penny money because I had lots of bills because with my wife. She had a lot of medicine and a lot of doctors. She had eye doctors and she had medical doctors and all kinds of money.
Yeah. Boy, he was mad. I said it. The minute you left, I went up and there wasn't nothing, you know. She was mad.
Well, I don't think he understood. That's why I told him what I told him. So
I,
that he,
I, 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 understood.
So he understood why you sounded mad, you know.
Yeah, well.
Because all you was doing was trying to explain to him that it wasn't working for you.
Yeah.
And you have a hard time
doing
this. And I understand you, but I knew he wasn't understanding.
Yeah, yeah. And then the other thing was seeds. Seeds.
Seed. Yeah.
What's seed?
Seeds.
Seeds. Yeah.
Grass seeds.
Yeah, grass seeds. And they, he told me he was do it, and he hasn't done that.
He said, see, that was a problem. He never, they never started him with a work order. With Pete, Pete has a work order, and so does Dave. But I don't know why they didn't start with Scott. But somebody would ask him to do this, and somebody else would, and he was so busy, he couldn't get your seeds because he's got everybody else, see?
Oh, I see.
That's why he's went to this, so that they know that it only take him so long to do this job and so long, so they don't give him any more than what he can do in a day.
Yeah, I see.
So that's why you didn't get your seeds.
Yeah. Okay, so let me see, you sent me many things, but you sent me I'll show you. Okay. Can you? This is the guy. You said that.
He's got new surgery.
Yeah.
And they don't have to. They don't have to cut anything.
I know.
Okay. That's why this is why I sent it to you.
Yeah.
It's a new technology.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah.
And then I went YouTube, and I went to all I spent about 2 hours.
Oh. On that one area.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And.
Yeah, because you got a lot of them.
Lots. And I wonder, maybe Don, what's his name? Bill Dunn?
Yeah.
Or maybe you? I could send them a video of me, but the thing, the bus, it makes all that thing is not useless. Can you help me? Help me get something. Can strokes, aphasia, can does he know where? Does he know? I was gonna send you an email telling you about this. Let me see. Operating room of the future. That's I'll be one to try it.
I don't know.
Could you somehow? I will send you Bill Dunn, maybe this is the future.
That's the future. Right?
Yeah, I'm ready for it.
I have no idea where you would get any more information than what you were getting right there.
No. This guy, Toby Fortman, this guy, very good, this guy too,
it says insight up here.
Yeah. I know this.
That looks like that might be the company. Insight Tech brings therapy into focus. Insight Tech. Let me look.
There was So this I know that they would do it. Yeah.
$100,000.
Well, I don't know, maybe not.
Yeah, I can't find anything where they're apparently running through the hospital like Mayo Brothers and specialists. They're going through. They're not, well, like I'm saying, they have to pay for all that equipment, so the first ones is going to be an awful expense. And there's no way you can get a cheap one.
It's time?
About 15 minutes.
Did you? What happened?
I didn't find anything.
No. There's lots of things. There's lots of things to find. There's lots of things.
I didn't get to do that.
Look. Yeah.
You're looking for some place to go to use that equipment, right?
Yeah. Well, that's got to be.
You're going to have to go through a hospital or a doctor to do that. I can't do it. Bill Dunn can't do it.
How do you know?
I know that.
What?
I know that. I know that you, these companies will not deal with the public. We are the public.
Well.
You have to be diagnosed and be able to tell that outfit exactly what your problem is.
Let me. See.
What?
Look.
Technician, yeah. What about it?
This was, where is, this is, see?
Yeah.
Do you think, and then, and you can go like this, and this is what you get. Can you help me?
Well, yeah, I can help you, but I
well, just think about it. Think about it.
I don't know.
Think about it, and well, it's almost time, so
it's packed up.
Yeah, so just think about it. But I think that you were you sent me this, right?
Yeah, because I thought you'd be interested.
Yeah, and I spent a lot of time, and I can. I can do a video. The School of Medicine of the Future. I'm not good at that. Can you write it? The School of
School?
Yeah.
School.
Medicine?
That's a C, it shouldn't be a
Can't
C.
Write it over.
All right. Of the future, that's right. Yeah. Oh. School of Medicine of the Future, yeah.
Okay. So, that's good. Fantastic. We need to find out more about that. But I can't do that. I can do it somewhat, but I'm always thinking about you or Bill Dunn or.
I have to tell you about Bill Dunn. Monday Judy took me to lunch. And she wanted to get a hold of Bill. So she called on the cell phone. He didn't answer. So we went out and ate, and she was bringing me home. She called him again. And he was home. And he answered the phone. But she said, I've been trying to get a hold of you. Well, he said, I went and exercised. Oh, she said, I was worried about you. And I don't know, she had something to tell him. But she called me that evening, and she says, I've taken Bill to the hospital. I said, yeah. And she says, when I got home, she says, after a little while, it was dinner time, and I went, and Bill was sitting in his chair. And I said to him, aren't you going to fix dinner? And he says, what time is it? And she says, dinner time. Oh, what day is it? Well, she told him the day, and she thought, this is odd. And he says, I can't remember anything. And she started questioning him, and sure enough, he couldn't remember what happened that day or anything, or he didn't know why he was sitting in the chair. So she called her nurse friend, told her about it. She says, take him right to the hospital. So she took him to the hospital, said that he had had a slight heart, I was going to say a thick heart, well, had a stroke, slight stroke a couple years ago, and that he don't know where he is. So, boy, they rushed him right to a room, and all kinds of nurses and everything was around. They were thinking that he had still had a mini stroke. But the heart doctor said, no, we got to take a head scan. So at 10 o'clock last night, they took a head scan. And my daughter called me about 9 o'clock this morning, said that they couldn't find nothing. They've released him. He's at home now. And there's nothing wrong with him. They can't find anything wrong, but they don't know why he's had a lapse of memory.
That's odd.
He's had a little bit of glimpse of that, of loss of memory some time back. Didn't last long, just a short time, you know, but he didn't pay much attention to it. This time, well,
and he doesn't come off, he doesn't have, Alzheimer's. He doesn't? Are you sure?
Well, the doctor says he don't.
Well,
I mean, that's the only thing I know is what the doctor says.
Yeah, but you have to, well, this is my opinion. This is my opinion, okay? You think, and then you go to the doctor, and it doesn't sound what it, like it, It doesn't sound right. So he so I'm, so let's say I'm, say I'm the man, I'm the patient. And I go through and I say, I don't know about that. Let me try a second doctor, a third doctor, a fourth doctor, and you find that sometimes they're different opinions. Different opinions, you know. One says this, and then the other says that, and the other thing, these, and the other. And I go, so that means that you can't trust the doctor. I mean, maybe it's good, maybe it's not good. You have to go to another doctor. That's all. If there's two doctors or three doctors, if the three doctors, they all agree, then he's right. Right? But if they disagree, then you go, well, what's the new? That's interesting. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Let me see. Okay. Boy, that is really bad.
That is.
Really bad. That is really bad.